Can you really know your PC is clean and malware-free? No. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. The harsh reality is that there's no way to prove your computer is not infected or somehow compromised. Even running multiple scans using multiple tools, you still cannot be completely, absolutely, 100% certain. You can't prove a negative. It's a philosophical reality that we have to apply to our systems and the possibility of malware. Now, even though 100% certainty is, by definition, unachievable, we can certainly get close. Pragmatically speaking, a clean scan using up-to-date anti-malware tools usually means that the machine is clean. If you're concerned, an additional scan with a different tool increases that confidence dramatically. If you follow the common advice to run a complete anti-malware scan on your machine and that scan comes up clean, that's a really good sign that your machine is probably clean. It's not absolute proof, that doesn't exist, but it shows a high likelihood of everything being just okay. Now, how do you know if you have malware or if you've been hacked? There's a relatively common list of signs that might indicate malicious activity. It's just not a helpful list. Here's the thing. Each one of these signs can happen for legitimate, non-malicious reasons. Some are more likely than others to indicate a problem, but once again, there are no guarantees. So, for example, your security software reports an issue. Now, to be fair, this is pretty close to a sure sign. Security software can still produce false positives, of course, but if yours reports something that is going on, you probably should pay attention to it and investigate further. Sudden performance degradation. This can happen for so many different reasons, and malware is only one. Hardware problems, software updates, and even normal background activity can all manifest as your machine suddenly slowing down. Slow or erratic internet behavior. Same thing. This can happen for many different reasons. Networking problems, website problems, and once again, normal background activity can all manifest as the internet seeming to have issues. Even other machines that share your internet connection can affect your computer's internet speed and behavior. Unfamiliar pop-ups or fake security alerts. Unfamiliar pop-ups happen all the time. They're generally worth paying attention to, not for malicious activity, but because they're probably trying to tell you something about your system. The one frustrating example is the scary security alert pop-up. More often than not, it's a scam and has no implications on your machine at all. The pop-up is usually not even on your computer, but on a website that's been compromised. Odd behavior. The most common assertion I see in this category is when people's mouse pointer begins to move on its own. They're convinced that they've been hacked or there's malware at play. Now, it could happen, but 99 times out of 100, it's something as simple as a flaky mouse or dirt underneath it. Almost every behavior that could result from maliciousness has also completely benign explanations. Failure to boot or repeated crashes. These days, malware tries to hide and keep running. It no longer tries to crash your machine. Most of the time, a boot problem or frequent crashes are due to hardware issues or a problem with the software installed on your machine, including the operating system itself. So the symptoms tell you that you may have malware or not. And if you don't have these symptoms, you may still have malware or not. There's always uncertainty. What you need to do is stack the deck in your favor. And it all comes back to, I guess I'd call it my litany of safety. Keep all software as up-to-date as possible. Use up-to-date security tools and make sure that the database of known malicious software is being updated regularly. Use a firewall. Your router is usually enough. Know what devices are on your network and whether you can trust them or the individuals that use them. For example, you might configure your network to protect yourself from your less tech-savvy guests or your more adventuresome children. Don't click on suspicious links or open suspicious attachments. Hint, all links and attachments are suspicious until proven otherwise. Avoid shady websites. Now, shady is definitely difficult to define, but it generally falls into sites that promise things that are too good to be true or use overly dramatic wording to get you to visit. Don't install unfamiliar programs without first doing your research. To start, make sure you really need what it is you're thinking of installing. The unfortunate bottom line here is that you are the weakest link. But to be fair, so am I. There's just no way to be completely certain that you don't have malware. The only thing you can do is hold to those best practices so that you don't invite malware in to begin with. Sadly, it could be very tempting to sidestep those processes just this once because of something enticing. Just remember, there's no tool that can protect you from yourself. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/180648. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.